For many of you, you may know that I've moved to America, and I'm living in New Mexico now, and we're here at the premier summertime bouldering destination in New Mexico, and it's October, so if it's not good, that's why. Let's go.
Hello, I'm back, I'm alive, I've not been shot yet. When you go climbing in New Mexico, it's not as easy as just driving to Stanage in 20 minutes and then walking for 5 minutes and then climbing whatever you want and then being home for whenever. So you've got to really plan it out. It often involves camping over, so I've acquired a new hammock because I left my hammock in the UK, a new sleeping mat because I left my sleeping mat in the UK, and I've been borrowing a sleeping bag because I left my sleeping bag in the UK. So now I've got my camping gear. We just go and camp in like a scary forest full of bears and wolves and all kind of things that can eat you. Before we go bouldering the next day. Today we went to Posos, I think it said, or Posos. Someone told me how to say it, but I can't actually remember. I can't understand the accent, that's it. I just have no idea what any of them are saying. So this place is apparently New Mexico's premier summertime bouldering destination. However, it's not on the mountain project, which is like UKC for America. So that's how exclusive it is. Yeah. There is a guidebook, but it's sold out after one limited print run, so I don't think I'll ever be able to get my hands on one, which is a bit unfortunate. I warmed up on like a V0 and a V1, which was just like piss easy. And then I climbed this bad boy called Allergic Reaction, which was a V2. So obviously I'm still getting quite used to the rock and quite used to the grades. It's really, really sharp, this rock, and it had quite a committing move at the top. And I actually got a bit scared, which you can kind of see here in 4K, captured with the new GoPro, thanks to GoPro for fixing my GoPro. So we just played around for a bit, did a few V2s. I tried this V3. I'm not sure if it's I got it on camera. If I did get it on camera, it'll be on the screen right now, matching this voice recording. This is how much preparation I do for the voice recording. I don't actually watch all the footage back because it just takes too long, and I'm spending too much time in the lab, not enough time editing. So I'm a chemist, by the way, for those who didn't know. Yes, New Mexico's premier summer bouldering destination. Yep. Now it's raining. So this is the main event of the day, a three-star V4 called the Glass Coffin. So I was reading the guidebook the night before at the campfire, and I read about this one, and I read the description, and I thought, no way do I want to try that. Oh, we went in this cool little cave thing, and ta-da, I didn't know this was Glass Coffin. I didn't know this was a V4, but I got on it anyway. So the first few times we tried it, we didn't do the full thing, because it's in like this pit. So you can see I'm actually in the pit fully and trying it properly. The first move is probably the hardest move, the first two or three moves, getting up to this massive flake, and it's just on these dirty, disgusting, greasy crimps, and it doesn't help when everyone else is trying them. But we made it work. My right foot was on this tiny, tiny foothold, and I don't know how it didn't slip. You know the kind of thing when you've just got to focus the whole time on, like, it not coming off? I don't know how it didn't come off.
Commit.
So you go up to this flake, and then you bump the left hand, and then you bump the left hand again. And this is where the beater, we weren't sure of what to do. So initially...
Nice, come on.
I was trying this. So as you can see, I bumped my left hand, bumped my left hand again, and then was trying to bump it a third time and do this massive reach. The only issue was the right foot wasn't that great, and then I got quite close onto the left hand, but it just also wasn't that great. And then we watched the master do it. So as you can see, Logan did it with... bumping the left hand again, and then just yarding off the left hand up with his right hand into the jug, and then just finishing it like a piece of cake. So now it's my turn. I wonder if I can do it. Yes, of course I can do it. I wasn't going to bait you out and play a video of something that I couldn't do. After changing my beater, I got up there, and then it was quite high, and I was thinking, like, oh, bollocks, like, this is a bit scary. I know there's loads of pads, but it's fine. So you go out to the right in this crack, and I was, like, fishing around for a fist jam. You can see me, like, looking for this jam, but it just wasn't there. But it was fine because there was a good hold there, and I just yeeted myself up. The top was like a mega jug, and I just pulled myself over. And just as it started to rain, I live in a bloody desert.
I fucking fly 8 hours and then 4 hours to live in a fucking desert, and we get rained off. I could get this at Stanage.
I've got that summertime sadness.
Brilliant. So thanks for watching this video. First video in America, land of the free, home of the brave, and also home of the fucking water, despite us being in a desert. If you enjoyed it, please like it. If you are a company, please sponsor me. Now I'm in a new country, I've got a whole new opportunity for companies to sponsor me. So if you're an American company, sponsor me. If you're a British company, you could sponsor me and get big in America. Or if you're an American company, I've got quite a few British viewers, so you can, you know, get big there. So it's like a win-win. Yeah, see you next video. Move! Move! Move!